Good morning, children. Stay safely at home. So today, after a long time, I am starting again a new chapter, that is household circuits and the electric power transmission. Now, electric power is generated in power generating stations, and I hope you can remember that there are different kind of power generating station. Hydroelectric power is there, thermal power stations are there, but here remember that whatever be the type of generating station, electricity is always generated at 11 kilovolt. What is the voltage at which electricity is generated? That is 11 kilovolt. Very important point. And this is the first topic and very important topic. And that's why you must learn and remember this topic, that power is generated, electric power is generated at power generating station at which voltage? 11 kilovolt. All right. So, I have written it, you see, underlined. Electric power is generated at the power generating station at 11 kilovolt. Now, the question is, why at 11 kilovolt? Alright. Now, if the power is generated over, means above 11 kilovolt, then what happened? You know, insulation difficulties arises. What is that? Try to understand. Now, when the power is generated at the station, then you know the power is transmitted within the station only, you know, from one part to another. And you know that this one electric power is generated. Now, what is the meaning of, now sorry for the disturbance. Now, what is the meaning of that 11 kilo, why, means what is the meaning of the insulation difficulties? Insulation difficulties, as I said, that when the electricity is generated at the power station, then it is transferred also from one part to another, isn't it? And there are different, means several employees there working there. Workers are working within the power station. All right. Now, if so that the cable through which the electric power is generated, it should be insulated properly. Now, if you see any electric wire or electric cable, you will see there is a plastic cover above it, isn't it? Why? Because plastic is an insulator of electricity. So, when the current will pass within the electric wire, then what will happen? That current will not come in contact of the user or any worker, isn't it? Now, if the voltage becomes very high, then if you give that insulation cover, then also what will happen? The voltage is so high, it will be able to break the insulation. The thing that happens in case of lightning, I hope you can remember, whenever lightning takes place, how the lightning takes place? That a heavily charged cloud come above the ground, then you know that cloud is having so much voltage, potential is so high that it can break the insulating property of air between the cloud and the ground. So generally air do not conduct electricity, but due to that very high voltage, what happens? The air, it transmits the electrons either from the cloud to ground or ground to cloud. Okay, whatever it is. It means what? That when the voltage is very high, the high voltage is able to break the insulating property of any material kept near it. Okay, so that what is happening in the power generating station, if the voltage is higher than 11 kilovolt, then if you use any insulating material above the transmitting cable, then it won't work. Okay, so it will cause the insulation. That's why what will happen if anybody come in contact with that transmitting cable, what will happen? Electric shock the person will get. And you know that electric shock of very high voltage is deadly for any living being. Okay, so that is the problem, that if the voltage is higher than 11 kilovolt, it causes insulation difficulties. Now, in the answer, when you are writing, you don't have to explain the way I have explained, that elaborate explanation you don't have to write. Only thing you have to write is that the voltage higher than 11 kilovolt causes insulation difficulties. This is the point, this is the key word you have to mention. All right. So question may arise that why not less than 11 kilovolt? Now you understand it. This part, explanation part also you don't have to write. I'm just explaining you. You know that power is given by voltage into current. All right. So power generated at the electric power station, that is depending on the capacity of that particular power station, it is constant. Okay, so V into I is equal to constant. Now you see, if you make less, V less, all right, then what will happen? I will be high, I will be more, isn't it? Now we know that whenever a high current passes through a conductor, it will produce heat according to this formula, I square RT. Okay, so you see, when the current is high, then what will happen? Due to the high current along the transmitting cable, heat will be produced, a large amount of heat will be produced. Can you use that heat to cook your food? Can you use the heat to warm the water for bathing or anything? No, not at all. So what is happening? This heat energy produced, this is the wastage of electrical energy, wastage of electric power generated. All right. So that's why what you can write, when the generation at voltage lower than 11 kilovolt involves very high current and hence causes power loss. Okay, so this is the first question, important question from this chapter, that at which voltage electric power is generated at generating station and why. This is the question. What should be the answer to the point answer? Electric power is generated at the power generating station at 11 kilovolt, because if the power is generated at voltage higher than 11 kilovolt, it will cause insulation difficulties. And if the power is generated less than 11 kilovolt, it will produce high current, thereby it will cause power loss. Okay, so this is the first topic. Please, I am telling you that kindly learn and remember this topic till your board exam, everyone. So electric power is generated at 11 kilovolt, but we know that the power generating stations are never situated near the near the consumers, isn't it? They are generally far away from the locality. So after generating electric power at the power generating station, it should be transmitted through a long distance to reach to the consumers. All right, now what is done? Electric power, although it is generated at 11 kilovolt in the power station, but it is never transmitted at that low voltage, 11 kilovolt. Okay, it is always transmitted, electric power is transmitted at 132 kilovolt. So just imagine, from 11 the power, the voltage is step up to 132 kilovolt. All right, now the question is why. Okay, why electric power is transmitted at very high voltage? So this is the second very important topic and question from this chapter. The question is, at which voltage electric power is transmitted and why? This is one way the question you may get, or you may get the question like this, that why the electric power is transmitted always at very high voltage. So you have to understand that electric power, electricity or electric power, anything you can write, it is transmitted at 132 kilovolt, means at very high voltage. Why? The first point, the first thing is that this, it reduces the loss of electrical energy in the form of heat energy along the transmitting cable. Okay, why? Just understand it. I said that P is equal to V into I. It is constant. Alright. So, if you make V very high, then what will happen? I definitely will be very low. So, when I is low, thus look at this. What will be the heat generated? I square RT. So, as I is low, what will happen? The amount of heat energy generated along the transmitting cable will be very less. Okay, so I have written this is point wise that as it reduces loss of electrical energy in the form of heat along the transmitting cable. Okay, and what is the reason? This is the reason. Alright, now whatever I have written within the bracket, if you are unable to write, no problem. At least write down the sentence what I have written. Now, second point, why it is transmission is done at very high voltage. This transmission at very high voltage also reduces the cost of transmission. Okay, how it reduces the cost of transmission, understand it. If the voltage is very high, then we have got current will be low. So, when the current is low, then you know that V is equal to IR, isn't it? So, what will happen? You have to use the cable whose resistance is high. It should offer high resistance, then only the current will be low. So, high resistance means what? You know that R is given by rho into L by A. Rho is the specific heat, you can say rho is the specific resistance of the material of the wire. So, here as we are not changing the material, so rho is constant. Then what about L? L is the distance between the consumer house and the power generating station. That also you cannot alter. So, L is also constant. So, you see, you can only control R by controlling A. That is the area of the cross-sectional area of the cable. Okay. So, you see, if R is high, then what will happen to A? A will be less. Means you can use a thin cable for the transmission. So, when it is a thin cable, then you see, and I hope you have observed that when the electric cables are taken, then at certain distances, electric poles are there. Why the electric poles are there? Because electric poles, they support the weight of the electric cable, isn't it? Because you cannot use a continuous only one cable from the generating station till the consumer house. Okay, so to support its weight at in between this transmission process, electric poles are there, isn't it? So what will happen if the weight, if you use the cables which is having thin, which are thin, or which is having less cross-sectional area, then the weight of the cable will also be less. So, to support the cable, you need to build up less number of electric poles. So, what it will do? Less number of electric poles means it will reduce the cost of transmission. Okay, so this is the second important question from this chapter. At which voltage electric power is transmitted and why? What should be your answer? Electric power is transmitted at 132 kilovolt. Why? The first point, as it reduces the loss of electrical energy in the form of heat energy along the transmitting cable, and second point, as it reduces also the cost of transmission. So, kindly learn this topic also. So, how the electricity is transmitted from the power station to city consumer, you have to understand that. Okay. Now, here, before understanding how it is transmitted, you have to understand that electricity always when transmitted from one place to another, then we use three lines for it. All right. One line which is known as the live line, all right, that is maintained at very high voltage. Means whatever be the voltage or at which electricity is transmitted, that voltage, live line will be maintained at that voltage. And live line you may consider as if that is the entry of the current within the circuit. Or you may consider live line is the line or the path along which electricity enters into a circuit. Okay. Then there will be a second line that is known as the neutral line. Neutral line is maintained at zero voltage, and neutral line is considered as the exit for the electric current from an electric circuit, because you know that electricity, when it passes, then electricity always passes through a closed path. If there is a break in the path, electricity cannot flow. So you see, whenever electricity is passing, then it should enter through one path, and then it will enter into any particular device, any particular electric circuit, then it has to come out from it. So along which path electricity will come out, that is neutral line. Okay, so you must remember two important points related with lifeline and neutral line. What are the important points? Lifeline is maintained at high voltage, and lifeline, through the lifeline, current enters into a electric circuit or into an electrical device. Okay, then neutral line, it is maintained at zero voltage, and neutral line is considered as the exit for the electric current. Or you may say this way, that along the neutral line, current comes out from an electric circuit or an electrical device. Okay, then the third line is known as the earth line. Earth line is used for safety purposes, and earth line is also maintained at zero voltage. I have written here the points. Okay, the points are just in short I have written, and elaborately verbally I have said, so you must note down in your own way. Just blindly do not copy it from the whiteboard, please. As I said, that lifeline, it is maintained at high voltage. This is the first point you have to remember regarding the lifeline. Second point is that I have written, you must write current. Current enters into the circuit through the lifeline. Alright, here as the space is less, board is small, so I have written in short, both the points I have written in short. You please write down it elaborately as I said it verbally in your notebook. Then, for neutral line, what will write? First point, it is maintained at zero voltage. Second point, through the neutral line, current exit from an electrical circuit. Okay? Then, the third line, it is known as the earth line. Earth line is also maintained at zero voltage. And remember, earth line is always connected to ground, to earth. That's why the name is earth line. Earth line, why it is connected and why it is used, that details in I will discuss later on in this chapter only. Now I am not going to discuss. Just remember, earth line is used for the safety purposes. Okay, because you have seen that current is entering through the lifeline and current is coming out from the neutral line. Then what is the purpose of the earth line? Earth line is for safety purposes, safety of the user as well as safety of the appliance. Later on in details, I will discuss about the earth line. Only thing you remember about earth line is that earth line is also maintained at zero voltage. Earth line is connected to ground, and earth line is used for safety purposes, for safety of user as well as electric appliances connected in the circuit. Okay, now you come back to the transmission part. So you just look at the diagram. First, it is PS. PS is not the police station, PS is the power station. So at the power station, power is generated at 11 kilovolt. All right, then you see through the live neutral earth line, it is entered into the grid substation. As the space is small, I have written the means abbreviation I have written. You please write down in your notebook the full term. It is grid substation, GRID, grid substation. Alright, now in the grid substation, what is there? There is a step up transformer. Okay, what is transformer? Transformer is a device which can change the alternating current. It can increase the alternating current or alternating voltage, and it can decrease also the alternating voltage. So you see here, within the grid substation, there is a step up transformer. What the step up transformer is doing? It is stepping up the voltage from 11 kilovolt to 132 kilovolt. Alright, so that's why there is a step up transformer in grid substation. And grid substations are generally situated just after the power generating station. Then between grid substation and the next substation, which is known as the main substation, there is a long gap. Okay, so the electric cables are supported by the electric poles. I have drawn only one electric pole, but remember there are several electric poles between grid substation and main substation. You too do not draw several poles. I have just told you what is actually happens in our in practice what actually we do, that I have said. But you too do not draw several electric poles, only electric wall pole, in electric pole you draw. So you know electric pole is very long, height is very high. It is high. Why it is high? Because you see, the electric power is transmitted at 132 kilovolt. So can you use insulation for 132 kilovolt? Not at all. And you know 132 220 volt shock is enough to kill one person. All right. So 132 kilovolt, if it this cable, if we set it near the ground, then you know what will happen. So that's why it needs to be supported and it needs to set at a height. That's why the electric pole is very long, and that's why the diagram I have drawn like this. Okay, so the electric pole is not doing anything, it is just supporting the load of the cables, the weight of the cables. All right, then what is happening? The electricity at 132 kilovolt, it is entering into main substation. Now inside the main substation, what is there? There is a step down transformer. From the name only one can make out. Here you see step up transformer. What is the meaning? Transformer is increasing the voltage from 11 kilovolt to 132 kilovolt. And in the main substation, there is a step down transformer. Now you see what the step down transformer is doing. Look at the diagram. 132 kilovolt electricity entering into the main substation, but what is the voltage, at which voltage electricity is coming out? There are two outlets here. One has gone to heavy industries, and what is the voltage? 33 kilovolt. And another line, it has entered into intermediate substation. Okay, and it is also 33 kilovolt. So what the step down transformer inside main substation is doing? Decreasing the alternating voltage from 132 kilovolt to 33 kilovolt. So you have to remember all these informations. Okay, intermediate substation, what is there? There is the step down transformer. What is its purpose? What is its function? It is decreasing the voltage from 132 kilovolt to 33 kilovolt. Now this 32 kilovolt is fed to heavy industries. Heavy industries means what? The industries where the appliances are very heavy, and to run it you need high voltage. That's why it is known as heavy industries. Okay, the appliances or the machines that is used in this industry, they are very heavy, and that's why to run them we need high voltage. That's why high electrical energy, so high voltage. So you can say that 33 kilovolt is the power at, sorry, the voltage at which electricity is supplied to heavy industries. Now you see the next line, 33 kilovolt again entering into the intermediate substation. From the intermediate substation, again there are two outlets. One outlet has gone to light industries. As the space was not there, I could not complete the word industries. I have written indus only. You must write it properly. Light industries. Now light industries means what? Light industries means the industries where the machines or the appliances used are lightweight. So to run it, we do not need very high power, very high voltage. So 11 kilovolt is enough to run the machines which are not very heavy, just like in heavy industries. Alright, so that's why you have to remember only the information that at which voltage electricity is supplied at light industries. What is the voltage? 11 kilovolt. And 11 kilovolt also the voltage at which power is generated in electric power station. So you must remember these two facts. Then you see from the intermediate substation, what is there? There is a step down transformer. What the step down transformer is doing in the intermediate substation, it is converting, it is reducing 33 kilovolt to 11 kilovolt. Okay, then 11 kilovolt it is entering into city substation, and city substation they are very nearby to our locality, and in city substation also there is a step down transformer. Okay, and what the step down transformer is doing, you just consider the output of the city substation. Output of the city substation is at 220 volt. Means the step down transformer within city substation, it is decreasing or reducing the voltage from 11 kilovolt to 220 volt. And we, the city consumers, we are getting electricity at 220 volt. Alright, so from this one, so many, one more question you may get. Okay, what are the questions? One by one, I am repeating that in which substation a step up transformer is used? In grid substation, step up transformer is used. What is the function of step up transformer in grid substation? The step up transformer, increases the voltage from 11 kilovolt to 132 kilovolt. Alright, then in a main substation, what is the function of a step down transformer? The step down transformer reduces the voltage from 132 kilovolt to 33 kilovolt. At which voltage electricity is supplied at heavy industries? Electricity is supplied at heavy industries at 33 kilovolt. Alright. Then inside intermediate substation, what is the power or which type of transformer is used and what is its function? In intermediate substation, step down transformer is used and it reduces the voltage from 33 kilovolt to 11 kilovolt. At which voltage electricity is supplied at light industries? Electricity is supplied at light industries at 11 kilovolt. Alright. Then what is the name of the substation which is located or which is situated near the locality, that is city substation? What kind of transformer is used in city substation and what is its function? In city substation, a step down transformer is used and it reduces the voltage from 11 kilovolt to 220 volt. Then another, and this is the most frequently asked question, at which voltage and frequency electricity is supplied to the city consumers? So you must remember it. Voltage is 220 volt and frequency is 50 hertz. This is the very important point. You should remember it rather lifelong. That at which voltage and at which frequency electricity or electric power is supplied at household and to the city consumers? At 220 volt, and what is the frequency? 50 hertz. Remember, this frequency and the voltage, it changes from one country to another country. In India, this is the voltage and frequency generally is maintained. That 220 volt and 50 hertz is the voltage and frequency at which electricity is supplied to the city consumers or to the household. Now in household connection, all the connections are made in parallel with the main. Means if you consider that your study room, there is a fan, there is a bulb, there is a point, electric point for connecting your laptop or the computer, anything. Then all these connection are done, always it is done in parallel. Never the household electric connections are made in series. Now the question is why the household connections are made in parallel with the mains? Okay, Because you see, when you are connecting all the appliances parallel, then you see they will be connected to 220 volt supply independently. And I hope you can remember the power thing. This part you do not write, do not draw anything. Just you consider. Suppose there is a fan and there is a bulb you are connecting in parallel with the electric mains. Alright, electric mains is 220 volt. Then you see the voltage across the fan also 220 volt and voltage across the bulb also 220 volt. I hope you can remember the power rating of an electric appliances. All, for all electric appliances, the power ratings are given 220 volt, 10 watt or 100 watt, like this it is given. Means the if the appliance you want that appliance will work independently normally, then it should be connected to 220 volt. When it is connected to 220 volt, then only it will absorb 100 watt power. It will consume 100 watt power. Okay. So for normal working of every appliances, the voltage across the appliance should be 220 volt. So it is possible only when the connections are made in parallel. Alright. So that is the first point written, that each appliance gets connected to 220 volt supply, which is its voltage rating for its normal working. This is the point. Okay. So you see, it should be connected in parallel. This is the first reason. Second reason, just you see, if you connect them in parallel, then what is happening? Suppose for any reason the fan is not working. So you see, when the fan is not working, then also the bulb will work. The current will continue to flow. Now suppose it is happening that the bulb get fused and it is not working. Then you will see that as the bulb is getting fused, then also the fan will work. But you see, if you connect them in series, then what will happen? Suppose instead of connecting them in parallel, you have connected them in series. Then what will happen when the fan will not work? Then bulb will also not work. Okay, so why the household connections are made in parallel? This is the second reason, that each appliance operates independently and without being affected by the presence or working of the other appliance. If the bulb works or not, fan will work. If the fan works or not, the bulb will work. It is possible only when the connection is done in parallel. It is also very important question. This is the third important question topic of this chapter, that how the electric household connections are done in different houses. Household connections are always done in parallel with the mains. What is the reason? The first reason is that for this type of connection, each appliance gets connected to 220 volt supply for its normal working. And second point, each appliance operates independently without being affected by the presence or working of other appliances. This part is explanation part. Please do not copy it in your notebook. So the next question will arise, that why the household connection are not done in series. So you see, why the household connections are not made in series. First you understand that, I am just showing you, if the connection is made in series, then what will happen? Every appliance won't get that 222 voltage. Just you see, if you connect them in series, this voltage is 220 volt. Means what? If you consider this is V1, this is V2, then V1 plus V2 is 220 volt. So neither the fan nor the bulb getting its operating voltage 220 volt. Okay. So this is the first point written. Each appliance cannot operate at its rated voltage. What is the rated voltage? 220 volt. Why it cannot operate? As voltage of the source gets divided in all appliances. You see, it is getting divided into, here I have drawn two appliances. If more than two appliances, then again it will get more less voltage. It will get less voltage. Alright. Then second point, you know that when the appliances or any resistances are connected, all the appliances are having some resistance, okay, and when the resistances are connected in series, then what happened to the equivalent resistance? You know equivalent resistance is R1 plus R2 plus R3. So what is happening? Equivalent resistance, it increases. So when resistance increases, then what happens to current? Current decreases. Alright, so when the current decreases, then what happens to the electrical energy? Electrical energy or the electrical power that the appliance getting, that also reduced. Alright, so here the second point, that equivalent resistance of the circuit in series connection increases, thereby it reduces the current in the circuit. So each appliance will get less power. Okay. And third point, from your common sense only you can say, here you see, if the fan is not working, the bulb will not work. If the bulb is not working, the fan will not. If the fan is switched off, not working, getting damaged, leave it. If you switch off the fan, then what will happen? You cannot switch on the bulb. Alright, if you switch on the bulb, then the switch will not work. It means what? None of the appliance can be operated independently. One will be affected by the presence or working of the other. So these are also, this is the fourth important question, that why household connections are not done in series. So these three points you must note down and learn it. That's all for today. Thank you, girls.